Another record month for RV shipments. Campers see tons of illegal campfires amid the worst fire season on record. Camping World is expanding yet again. Two multi-million dollar motorhomes and more. It's time for the latest in RV and camping news. I'm Jason Epperson and welcome to the RV Miles News Roundup, where we provide you with all the latest in news and information about RVs, camping, and road trip travel. We start off this week with the continued rise in RV shipments. According to the RV Industry Association, July 2021 saw a record-breaking 44,537 total RV units shipped to dealer lots, an increase of 3.5% over this time last year, making this the best July on record for the industry. Towable RVs, led by conventional travel trailers, were up 3.4%, with 4,511 units shipped. Motorhomes finished up the month 3.9% compared to the same month last year, with 4,026 total units shipped. Now, to make sure all those RVs have a home to go to, Camping World recently announced an aggressive plan to continue its hold as the largest RV dealership in the country. Over the next 3 years, the RV giant plans to build over 20 brand new locations all across the U.S. on top of its slew of acquisitions that have already been going on. According to CEO Marcus Lemonis, the new location should add an additional 350 to 450 service bays. Cities in consideration include Lincoln, Nebraska, Kansas City, Kansas, Daytona Beach, Florida, and Cheyenne, Wyoming. Be on the lookout. A brand new Camping World may be opening up right down the street from you. As wildfires continue to leave a devastating footprint across the country, a recent survey from The Dirt found that 36% of summer campers reported seeing campfires in areas with burn bans. Already this year, more than 4.5 million acres have burned in 41,197 fires. And currently, the U.S. is at National Preparedness Level 5, which means there are no more firefighters to call upon. The Caldor fire has crept closer to the iconic Lake Tahoe area in California, spurring the first evacuation warnings for those inside the Tahoe Basin and a recommendation that tourists wanting to visit the area stay home. As of Thursday, only 12% of the Caldor fire was contained, with over 139,000 acres already burned. The National Interagency Fire Center reports that over 53,000 fires were started by humans alone in 2020. If you're camping in an active burn ban location, please, I can't stress it enough, do not start a campfire. The U.S. Department of Homeland Security recently announced the border will remain closed to our friends in the north until at least September 21st. The Canadian border has been open to Americans since August 9th, with proof of vaccination and other strict requirements in place. A couple months ago, we reported a California man who listed his 100-acre Ridgeline View property near Big Sur on the popular Hip Camp website was cited for illegally operating a campground. Now, another California man is facing similar issues in Cambria. Michael Buddy Campo, who listed his 3-acre site complete with 8 camping spots, bathroom facilities, and more, was recently informed his commercially zoned property was operating illegally. According to a report filed July 27th, Campo's property was found to have numerous unpermitted structures, including a cabin with sleeping facilities, a bathroom built on a flatbed trailer, a deck, and numerous cargo containers, along with unpermitted electrical, sewer, and gas lines. Campo was told to cease operations until appropriate permits can be obtained. This episode is sponsored by the Togo RV app, which is free, offering checklists, maintenance reminders, and more. But a $39 per year Togo RV Plus membership gets you RV-specific route navigation. Also, the RV Village social network, overnightrvparking.com, boondocking locations, and Road Trippers Plus trip planning, along with a whole host of discounts on RV products like tires and lithium batteries. You can get $10 off with the code RVMILES10X. In automotive news, soon your Chevy or GM truck will not shift into gear without a seatbelt buckled. GM will continue to expand its buckle-to-drive seatbelt interlock system, announcing plans to bring the tech to Silverado and GMC Sierras when redesigned models launch next year. The system prevents any vehicle from shifting out of park if the driver is not belted properly. Buckle to Drive was first introduced in 2020 as part of the company's Teen Driver Safety Suite on Colorado Traverse, Malibu, and Canyon models. Since then, GM has expanded the system into the Equinox and the Blazer. In trucks, it's going to make hooking up to a trailer really interesting, but it'll probably save some lives. Crude oil prices saw a decline of $5 last week, bringing the total cost to $62.32 a barrel. As of this recording, the national average gas price sits at $3.14 a gallon, down 3 cents from this time last week. AAA reports that this is the third week in a row gasoline demand has declined nationwide, leading some experts to believe we could soon start to see real relief at the pump. In a very unfortunate turn of events, two people were shot after a dispute erupted over loud music at a campsite. It was at the Bronig Lake RV Resort in San Antonio, Texas. According to police, a group of people got into an argument around 2:30 in the morning over loud music being played. At least two people were armed and they started firing at each other. One man was shot in the head and another in the leg. Both were taken to the hospital. Neither was listed as critical. The police detained three individuals, but charges have yet to be filed. In one of those you have to see it to believe it dashboard camera videos, a Colorado Springs man captured the moment a Jeep came unhooked from its Class A motorhome, rolling towards oncoming traffic, while the RV, oblivious to what had happened, completed its left-hand turn and drove on. Thankfully, the man who captured the video was in position to chase after the Jeep and safely stop it from rolling back into the intersection. His wife, who took over driving, was then able to chase the Jeep owner down and inform them of what happened. Thanks to the quick actions of one good Samaritan, the only damage reported, a broken hitch. And finally, if you've got a few million dollars burning a hole in your pocket, Dembel Motors, a new German car maker, has released its latest first-class luxury motorhome titled the Land Yacht. This massive motorhome features top-of-the-line appliances, roof-mounted solar panels, an enormous 270-gallon freshwater tank, onboard generator, and a garage, according to Dembel, big enough to hold your Ferrari. The Land Yacht features all the luxuries of a mansion on wheels and rides on a three-axle Mercedes chassis and is expected to come in at no less than $2 million. That's it for this week's RV and camping news. Please hit the subscribe button if you want more of these. And remember, likes are free and they help a lot. Here's last week's video if you missed it. And here's a great video that you haven't checked out yet. A lot of you very unhappy about this news about RV ladders. Bernie says, I'm on my third travel trailer and I have never used the ladder on any of them. A vertical ladder is dangerous. I much prefer an angled ladder, so I always use my extension ladder to go into the roof of my RV. It's just so much safer.